Hey guys, it's AJ. It's Wednesday on the Beaver Bunch. If you haven't yet done it, I'm trying out for the gaytravel.com travel guru so I can come to your country and hang out with you and have dinner and meet your family and tell them that you're gay for you, which would be perfect, which is a reason why you need to go to gaytravel.com, sign up, use this link below here, and just like my reviews of Long Beach. It takes like 3 minutes. Just do it. And now I'm going to talk to you about sex and marriage. So we got an email from someone who's dating a girl. They used to date off and on for 5 years. Now they're recently dating again. And now they have a 90-day rule where they're not going to have sex for 90 days. I don't know, that seems strange to me since you dated already. Like, I guess maybe you're waiting for it to... Maybe it's going to change now. Like, I don't know. If my girlfriend and I didn't have sex for 90 days after having sex on the regular... Somebody, I would go crazy, or it just, I would be so frustrated if we didn't have sex for 90 days. But you know what? Good for you guys. And as you wrote in your letter, it's nearing the end, and you're thinking about asking her to marry you. And like, how soon is now? Like, how do you know? I think that's what your question was. I was more into the whole, like, we haven't had sex for 90 days. Let's see. We've been talking about marriage, but you've been thinking about asking her. But you don't want to ask too soon. When would a good time to be to ask her to marry you? Well, here's the thing. Like, good job for you guys for being together off and on for 5 years. Like, anybody who's together for more than 3 years, in my mind, like, deserves some kind of, like, plaque or, like, a brick in a walkway commemorating that date. Because in the lesbian world, let's face it, relationships don't last that long. So good for you. Here's the thing, like, with my current girlfriend, like, the first month we were together, I was like, I'm gonna marry you, and we're gonna have kids, and it was just like a whirlwind, right? And now I'm like, whew, I don't know if I want to get married yet. Not that I, like, have a fear of getting married, it's like, huge commitment, and having kids, and I'm like, you're a teacher, are you sure you want to have kids? Like, you hang out with kids all day. But anyway, good for you guys for being together for 5 years. I think that... if it's been off and on for 5 years, there's something there that's pulling you guys together like two little cute lesbian magnets, then I say go ahead and ask her. In fact, that alarm on my watch means only one thing. Survivor's on. Hold on. Anyway, I think you should ask her because it's been a long time. 5 years is a long time to know someone and get to know them. And sure, ask her. And you know what? I just want to let you know I volunteer my services to be your officiant because I am an ordained minister. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Just gonna throw that out there. Christenings, baptisms, house cleansings, get the ghosts out of your house. Anything you need, you just call me. I can do it. Anyway, go ahead and ask her. I think 5 years is long enough. You know, we as a community of lesbians tend to jump into things super fast, and you know, I will admit I am guilty of looking at people's Facebook pages when they get into relationships. They're like, this is going to be my wife forever. And 3 months later, they're like dating someone else. And it's like, yeah, I knew it. So we, speaking as an umbrella term, tend to do that. Rennie's over here now. Just doing Rennie stuff. Anyway, can you see? There's her tail. I'll see you guys next Wednesday. I have to go watch Survivor. Just ask her to marry you. 5 years is far long enough. 90 days is too long to wait to have sex, especially if you've already had it. And especially if you haven't. I think like 4 dates is long enough. If you're getting along after 4 dates, just go ahead and see what you're working with, guys. See you next Wednesday. Bye.